track to the session of cleaning equipments. In continuation to the last video of cleaning equipments, today we are going to complete the manual equipments. Myself, Paramveer Singh, Associate Professor with Chitkara School of Hospitality. In today's video, we will study about purchase, use and care of various equipments like clothes, polish applicators, containers and sundry equipments. So let's begin. This chart you have seen in the last video also, and we have completed brushes, brooms, mops and box sweepers. Today we are going to complete clothes, polish applicators, containers and sundry equipments. And here is a list of mechanical equipments. So let's begin. Clothes. Various clothes are used extensively in wet and dry cleaning by housekeeping staff. For efficient and correct usage, clothes may be color coded and the staff should be well trained in their use. Color coding helps the GRA or other cleaning persons to easily distinguish between the clothes for what purpose they are being used. These may be divided into two categories, that is cleaning clothes and protective clothes. A variety of cleaning clothes are available in for specific purposes, like dusters, swabs, floor clothes, scrim, glass clothes, rags, wet clothes and chamois leather. We'll start with dusters. These are meant for dusting and buffing, basically to clean the dry dust. Soft, absorbent, plain or checked cotton material are ideal for dusters. When used for damp dusting, they must be sprayed with a fine mist of water or dusting solution. Dusters must be folded several times into a hand-sized pad before use, so as to provide a number of clean surfaces and avoid spreading dirt again to clean surface instead. So when you get a duster, you have to fold it into many folds so that to make it the up to the size of a hand pad, so that you will get many more clean surfaces. Swabs. These are all-purpose clothes made of soft absorbent material. They are used for wet cleaning and damp dusting of all surfaces above floor level. They are also used for cleaning sanitary fittings such as bathtubs and wash basins. The reason is because they are lint-free. And this is a picture of a swab cloth. Floor clothes. Floor clothes are bigger, thicker and made of coarser cotton material than all-purpose swabs. They are used to wipe WC pedestals and remove spills from floors. These are more absorbent than swabs and they are a little thicker. This is a picture of a floor cloth. Scrim. Scrim is a loosely woven linen material, and because of its high absorbency and lint-free nature, it is often used instead of chamois leather for cleaning mirror and windows. This is the picture of a scrim cloth. Glass clothes. These are used for wiping mirrors and drinking glasses, as they don't leave any residue like lint or threads behind, and it makes the glass more clean as compared to your normal cloth. And this is the picture of a glass cloth. Rags. Rags are disposable clothes usually obtained from the linen room or bought by the sack from the tailor. These are the, you can say, the residual of the main cloth, which are used for cleaning purpose. And once their use is finished, they can be thrown. They are used for applying polishes, and when they are dirty, you can throw them away. Wet clothes. Wet clothes should be absorbent and of a manageable size so that they can be wrung out by hand. They are used for mopping large floor areas. Chamois leather. Real chamois leather is the skin of an antelope, but now various cheaper limitations are available in the market. These simulated chamois leather are usually skewers, such that split sheepskin. Chamois leather can be used wet for cleaning windows and mirrors, and once it is dry, you can use it for polishing various metal surfaces. This is the picture of a chamois leather. Next is protective clothes. These include dust sheets, drugettes, hearth and bucket clothes. So we'll start with dust sheets. Dust sheets are made of any thin cotton material being above the size of a single sheet. Discarded bed sheets or curtains from the linen room are ideal for using as a dust sheet material. They are used to cover floors, furniture and other articles during spring cleaning or redecorating. So dust sheets are basically the discarded sheets what we get from the linen, and they are used as the dust sheets to cover various furniture or floor while painting is going on. So here's a picture. A dust sheet is laid on the staircase. Drugettes. These are made of coarse linen, fine canvas or clear plastic. They may be of the size of a carpet square or a runner. They are placed on the floor in doorways to prevent excessive dirt being tracked in or out during bad weathers and during redecorating projects. They are sometimes placed in the passage between the kitchen and the dining area as well to catch spills and debris. So these are basically, you can say, we place at the entrance to prevent excess dirt or sand or other particles from entering the room. Hearth and bucket clothes. These are made of thick fabrics and used to protect the carpet or flooring when a fireplace is being cleaned, or can be placed under buckets to prevent marks on the surface they are kept. They also catch splashes of water. Care and cleaning of clothes. Good care of clothes is important for efficient cleaning and for longer life. You need to take really good care of the clothes so that you can use them for longer life. In general, clothes may be washed in hot detergent water followed by rinsing and drying. Next is containers. Work becomes much easier and efficient if the staff is given appropriate containers in which they carry, transport, collect and store supplies and other items. Types of containers. The various types of containers used are as follows: buckets, basins, dustbins, sani bins, spray bottles, polish applicator trays, hand caddies, carts and trolleys. Buckets. These may be made of plastic or galvanized iron. Plastic buckets are more popular nowadays, reason being because they are lighter as well as they make less noise and they are easier to clean. Buckets to be used with mops may have one or two sections and may have a wringer device that can be detached for easy cleaning. Larger buckets should have caster wheels, which must be kept free of hair, fluff and dust so that you can easily move them from one place to other. Buckets should be thoroughly washed inside and out, every time they are used, and then allowed to dry before being stored so that the foul smell can be prevented. Next is basins and bowls. They are used to carry small amount of water, cleaning solutions or powders for cleaning small areas. Dustbins. The housekeeping department is concerned with dustbins in four areas: in guest rooms, in the service rooms, in public areas such as corridors or lobbies, and in waste collection areas. In guest rooms, these bins may be made of plastic or wood. Some properties also use jute or wicker bins. Individual dustbins in guest rooms may be lined with a disposable inner lining made of recycled paper or plastic. Dustbin bags are a good example of this. These bins must be emptied and wiped daily. They should be washed at least once a week. In the service rooms, these are used to collect waste from guest rooms. brought in by the room attendant's cart. In public areas, these bins may have a creative design since they are constantly on the view of the guest. So they have to be made of a decorative material from the outside. They should be emptied on daily basis. In waste collection areas, these are usually located outside the main building and are hidden from the view of the guest. These bins should be kept covered and emptied at least every alternate day. These are basically big dustbins where the garbage is put, and later on it is cleaned by the either by the municipality or by the contractor of the hotel. Sunny bins. These are metal or plastic bins with the lids. They are found in toilets for the collection of soiled sanitary towels. They should be lined with plastic or paper bags for easy cleaning. The bin must be emptied and wiped daily for the reason of hygiene. And disposable paper bags should be provided in the guest toilets for wrapping sanitary towels before discarding in the sunny bin. So here's the picture. It is a bin with a cover. Spray bottles. These may be used to apply a fine spray of water for cleaning solutions or cleaning solutions as required. The nozzle must be maintained clean by spraying clean, pure water through it after use. Once the chemical use is over, fill the bottle with the water and spray it so that you can clean, or the residual of the chemical has to be removed so that to avoid the hole of the nozzle to be blocked. Polish applicator trays. These are used in conjunction with a polish applicator mop for polishing floors with a liquid polish. These should be labeled with the type of polish that they hold. Cleaning them after use is difficult. Pour any excess polish back into the polish container. Soak the tray in small amount of solvent used to remove that applicator that particular type of polish. Wipe with rags and store. So polish applicator trays, they hold paint, they hold basically the polish, and once it is used, the excess can be poured back into the bottles, and you have to soak the tray in the solvent so that the excess polish can be removed, and after that you can wash and you have to store the trays for next use. Hand caddies, also called housemaids or chambermaid boxes. These were originally made of wood or metal, but nowadays usually made of plastic. They consist of a box with a handle and a fitted tray. They are used by room attendants for carrying cleaning supplies from room to room for guest room cleaning. This is the picture of a hand caddy, and the various cleaning agents are there inside it. Carts and trolleys. These are more useful than hand caddies when a large amount of supplies and items are to be carted or replaced. They are ideal for the efficient removal and carriage of smaller pieces of cleaning equipments, cleaning agents, linen and other rubbish items. They eliminate the time wasted in assembling equipments at the work location or moving them from one place to other. The various kind of trolleys and carts that may be used in the housekeeping department are maid's cart or room attendant's cart, janitor's trolley, mop wringer trolley and linen trolley. So we'll start with the maid's cart. Also called a room attendant's trolley or a maid's cart or a chambers maid trolley. This is perhaps the most significant piece of equipment in the housekeeping department. This is the picture of the maid's cart. You can see the center part has various shelves, and on the side you have two bags, below you have casters, and on top you have a box in which you carry all the equipments, and in the center the various shelves are there. You need to place your linen over there. The cart should be spacious enough to carry all the supplies needed by a GRA to complete half a day's room assignments. Since the cart is large and may be heavily loaded, it must be easily maneuverable. The idle cart would have fixed wheels at one end and casto wheels at the other so that you can easily move it. The cart should be well organized so that the GRA do not have to waste time in searching for supplies or make frequent trips back to the supply room and wasting the time. There is usually one such cart for each room section and it is stored in the floor pantry along with the other housekeeping supplies. Most of these carts have three deep shelves, the lower two for linen and the top portion partitioned shelf for small supplies. The carts also have a sack for soiled linen which is detachable, and also a trash bag which is also a detachable bag, and storage for vacuum cleaners and hand caddies. While arranging the linen on the cart, it should be kept in mind that the heavier linens must be placed on the lowermost shelf and the smaller or the lighter ones on the top shelf. Janitor's trolley. This is used for carting and storing cleaning supplies. It is used during the cleaning of public areas or any special cleaning projects scheduled for guest rooms. It includes a detachable trash bag and a place for storing cleaning agents and small pieces of cleaning equipments. This is a picture of a janitor's trolley. The piece of the mop wringer trolley, this piece of equipment consists of a mop and one or twin buckets with an attached wringer, all mounted on a trolley with caster wheels. It may have provisions for holding cleaning agents as well as a trash bag. A wringer is basically used to squeeze the mop. So this is the picture of a wringer trolley. Linen trolley. These are used for the transfer of clean linen from the laundry to the linen room or from the linen room to the floor pantries and so on. Linen trolleys may be made of aluminium or steel. Care of carts and trolleys. All carts and trolleys need to be kept clean, wiped daily and stored in a locked, dry, well-ventilated area when not in use. A thorough cleaning may be done once a week. The wheels may be oiled during the cleaning process. Next is polish applicators. These are usually oblong in shape for efficiency of application. The polishing head should slide out from the metal or plastic casing to enable easy replacement. Care and cleaning. Polish applicators should not be washed with water. Wiping away excess polish with newspaper or rags before it dries should suffice. It is important to label the applicator with the type of polish for which they are to be used so that each applicator is used with just one kind of polish to avoid mixing of different products. Other sundry equipments which are used in under manual equipments. Some other equipments such as following also aid in cleaning exercise in hotels, like step ladders or stool, cleaning rubber gloves, racks for holding brushes, dustpans, etc., airing rack for drying dry cleaning clothes, adjustable or extension ladders for public areas so that you can clean high areas, stirring paddle used to mix cleaning solutions, measuring cups to measure cleaning solutions, pickup pans to gather water collected by squeezes. They are like dust pans. Abrasive pads for the removal of localized heavy impacted soil by abrasion. Example, wire wool or steel wools. That's all for today. And in the next video, we will study about mechanical cleaning equipments. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.